Hey guys, I'm Mark Hanna, and I'm showing you what I've been doing for the last 17 years. This is Kona Oceanfront Gallery. I bought it from Weiland back in 2007, and we're bidding farewell to Kona at the end of the year. So today, being November 3rd, I'm gonna give you a little visual tour of the gallery and what we've been doing in here for 17 years. So come on, follow me. Come up the door. You can see we've been voted best art gallery consecutively for many years. Some of the artists, they would do their actual signatures right on the window. We have the two big showcase windows here, and then we're gonna come in the front door. So come on in, and as this sign says, welcome, come on in. It's really cool in here. That's because it's hot outside and it's nice and cool with air conditioning inside. So come on in. We're gonna go right into this first viewing room here. This is the first one that we come in. This is a little viewing room. Customers can sit down, view the art. We can change the lights. We have Heather Morris over here, fine art photography. This is all on die sub aluminum. You can see they're award-winning. She's fabulous. And she's located in here. We also have Ilza Sims. We have a few Golston pieces remaining. This is our friend Dave Golston, who passed away a couple of years ago, last month, as a matter of fact. And behind us here, we have our star of the gallery. These are some of her whimsical paintings. These are all originals. They're by Wanga. Some people call her Pearl. And we do have a beautiful piece in here that is by Daniel Moe. And you can see when we turn down the lights, it really comes to life. And then right outside the door here, we have more Daniel Moe. And then around this corner, this is Rod Cameron. Rod Cameron is a local artist who does this beautiful impressionism movement paintings that we're so glad to have in the gallery. People love Rod, and he's been painting in Kona for over 50 years. This is Dana Queen. Dana Queen, she's one of the original artists with Weiland Gallery way back in the day. The zebras up here are by her, this beautiful floral piece, these two little floral pieces. Right below here, we have a Derubis. And around the corner here, if we come through, we will see our Walfredo walls. Walfredo, personal friend of mine, been in the gallery the longest. His name is Walfredo Garcia. He's my golf buddy. He's my favorite artist and one of our top selling artists in the gallery. And you can see why. He does a vast array of Hawaiiana scenes of natural wonders in Hawaii, from eclipses to beautiful moonscapes. Here's a collaboration of him and Weiland. Don't have any Weiland in the gallery, but there are collaborations by Walfredo and Weiland. There's one of them. And then we have another one over here. This one is called I Como Mai. It's a collaboration between Weiland and Walfredo. And then behind us over here, we have Ben Requinio wall. This guy has been creating these beautiful wall sculptures in Kona for probably 50, 60 years. And he's a legend in these parts. Surfing champion. A lot of people come to Kona for surfing. And you can see he's got a beautiful array of metal and cold cast bronze sculpture on the wall. And then moving right along here, we still have more of Daniel Moe. These beautiful glass vases, they absolutely come to life with light being displayed properly. Behind the wall here, we have more Wanga, more cloisonné sand. She does everything with her patented process of colored sand that's permanent. And she emphasizes the detail of each piece with flat wire, all done by hand. She's our number one selling artist, and for good reason. You can see her versatility here. She does everything from real sea life to Picasso-ish to the whimsical for the cakey, as you can see down here and over here. These are so hard to keep in stock. They don't have a very good wall life. As you heard in grocery stores, they don't have good shelf life. That means they move quickly. Same with her art. More of the glass art that we carry in the gallery here. This is a collage of artists. We have Aria Glass, Jamie Strahula. We have more Daniel Mole, these waves. And then we have Malia Rideout, this beautiful glass sculpture down here. She's fabulous, one of the most talented artists in the gallery. And moving right along, we're gonna come over back over here. Ernest Young is on these two walls here. This gentleman has a great history. His father is the legendary Robert Thomas, or excuse me, his father-in-law, the legendary Robert Thomas. And you could see he's kind of emulated a lot of the technique that Robert taught him. It's very similar in technique and style. Around the corner here, we have Steve Barton, the wavy frame artist. And you can see that he's appropriately called the wavy frame artist because he's the innovator of these beautiful wavy frames. And then over here on this wall, we have Valerie Lapatina. She was last year's up and coming new artist. These are all beautiful pieces that we have by her. And then over here, we have Ilza Sims, more Ilza Sims, and RK Kobayashi Wood, right above. And then if we come around this corner here, and we look up on top on the catwalk, we have another collage of different artists, from Brian Pesman on the far left to Lee Reynolds, Joe and Eddie. There's Chris Lundy, another Wanga piece. Heather Brown, the last remaining piece by Heather Brown. Another Derubis piece up on top. Dan Mackin up on top, more Wanga. Here's a beautiful original, one of the best buys in the gallery. This was a $7,000 piece. We're selling for under $2,000 right now. That's an original Milan. And then we have our last Jim Warren. Jim Warren does this fantasy surrealism. He's right up here. Jim Warren, that's the piece there. Okay, and if you follow me, we'll come right over here to an original oil by Sashi. And right above, perhaps the most famous bronze artist on the planet. This is Nano Lopez from Colombia. And he's the most sought after bronze sculptor. These are quite heavy, solid bronze, very heavy. And as you can see, he does some very incredible work on each piece. And then moving right along behind us, we have Christopher Bella, good friend of mine, who another patented process that he uses here with his abstracts. These are to show water and lava. So you can see the colors accommodate which one he's revealing here. And then over here on the bottom, we have some Sigmund Abrin. This is ground metal painting, and he is just incredible. Okay, so next room we're gonna come in is another one of our viewing rooms. We bring the customers into a room like this, put the wall or the art up on the wall and give them a light show. We can adjust the lights, we can turn up the music, we can do a lot of things in here, but mostly we close the sales in this room and the customer sits on the couch, pretends they're at home, and views the art in different lighting. This is Sigmund Abrin, abstract contemporary mixed media. We love him. He incorporates a little realism in his abstract paintings. This is a tribute to Mary Monarch, the hula festival that they have every year where the top hula dancers in the Wahine and the Kani, they do their tribal warrior dances, and this is his tribute to them. We also have Barry Williamson, Koa extraordinaire sculptor here. He does this beautiful, incredible, unique stuff. These two glass sculptures here, these are by Tom Morose, and he is fabulous, as you can see. Around this area here, we have more Malia rideout. She's up here. This is her glass wall sculpture and paintings combined. All right, and then if we come over here, Rockwood. Rockwood is the premier tattoo artist of the stars. He just happens to reside here in Kona. And all celebrities that come to Kona, whether it be rock stars or athletes or musicians, they're coming here and getting their tattoos done by this gentleman here. But as you can see, his true passion, his true talent is in fine art. And these are just some of his pieces in here that we sell by him, and over here on the wall. This is our sold section over here. So as we sell them, they come off the wall and they go up here. This is our little trinket items. This is from Doug Miller, more Malia Rideout. We've got some Tim Wilson. We've got some David Crawford pens. This is mostly cash and carry. People get 2, 3, 4 of these at a time. Keeps us from having 0 days. Over here, we have more Ilsa Sims. This is her kintsugi, kintsugi, I guess is what it's called. The ancient art form of pottery, where as it's coming out of the kiln, sometimes it has cracks and they have to scrap it. What artists figured out how to do many years ago was fill those cracks with like molten gold. So this is 24 karat gold incorporated into this stoneware, and it's called kintsugi. We have a beautiful wine rack, which I'm probably gonna be bringing home. This is made of koa, and it's by Roy and Gloria Kobayashi. Okay, and here toward the back of the gallery where we have this magnificent ocean view backdrop. But this is Doug Perrine. He's our number 2 selling artist. These are all award-winning photographs. Doug Perrine is probably the most published photographer in the United States. He just happens to live here in Kona. And he's been on more covers than any other photographer in the United States. To land the cover on 1 or 2 nationally syndicated magazines, that's pretty impressive. He's been on over 350 covers. So we're very proud and privileged to have him in our gallery, and you can see why he's our number 2 selling artist. These are all on aluminum, so they're versatile, indoor, outdoor. You can take a garden hose and hose them down and can't hurt them. And right around the corner here is a gentleman named Arcade Latour. He has a very unique technique that he uses. This is printer ink that he uses and mixes chemicals in to give it texture, thickness, and then he does some other secret things that he won't reveal, but we absolutely love having him in the gallery, and we do a great business with him. And then up here we have more Scott Hansen sculpture. Scott Hansen's what we call stylized abstract surrealism. And as you can see, some are very realistic. This Honu is a good example of it. A piece that I own right here, together. And yeah, Scott is a good friend of mine. Very talented sculptor. And that's it. So this is what I've been doing for 17 years, and we're saying goodbye. So thanks for watching.
I just want to say that I'm really proud of my dearest friend here, Mark Hanna, and what he's accomplished. I was here back when he walked through this gallery to look at it to buy it that many years ago.
And 2007.
It seems like yesterday, and in some days it seems like a long time, but He's accomplished a lot. He's helped a lot of artists here in this area. He's helped a lot of people with employment in this area, and he's put together one beautiful gallery. I'm gonna miss coming here and seeing him and meeting the artists and his great employees.
And I'm just gonna miss it a little bit.
And I love this guy, and I'm proud of him.
Johnny was here in the beginning, he's here at the end, and we're bidding farewell to Kona after 17 years. We've both been in this town many, many times. Johnny used to come here before I lived here. So great memories for both of us. And it's about time to say goodbye. And we're saying goodbye, so thank you. And let me introduce you to my number one salesperson. This is Victoria. She's been with me forever. Victoria started with Wyman Galleries.
In 93,
before my time. And she's just one of the best salespeople. She's full of aloha, full of knowledge. People love her, and there's no wonder why she's been the number one salesperson in this gallery for many years. But she's saying goodbye to Kona Oceanfront Gallery, and she'll probably be here when the new art gallery opens, which is going to be Tabora Gallery. So we're still going to see more of Victoria. Okay. Bye-bye. Aloha.